front of them.
You'll know
now.
As well as I do that every single person that comes on this show has an interview beforehand, and we write down everything they say, because that would be the right way to do it. This, ladies and gentlemen, and maybe you, Mr. Brown, you might be watching this, because I think this is symptomatic with what's wrong with this damn country of ours. This is what I said. You're a typical lad, are you?
Actually, there's another word put into my mouth.
Quote, I'm bored so I drink, I ain't got a job, and I can't be going to look for one. There isn't much for me to do because I've been to prison, and I can't be bothered to write a CV, it's boring. Yeah. I pay for my beer because of yous.
I cannot explain why...
Shut your mouth.
Well, he's now trying to get booked. Okay.
Seriously.
Chris, that's another one of those lies.
What did you say?
I'm talking about the one Adolf went a bit too far. I never said such a thing.
You are one barefaced little liar.
See, you're telling the truth! You're telling the truth!
Liar. You are so, so wrong in what you think. What makes my blood boil is not you. Big hard man, aren't you? No, you're not. You're a little boy.
I've shared a platform with David Jid, who was once a leader of a Ku Klux Klan, always a totally non-violent one, incidentally.
You know, you think you're hard and everything. Do you know how stupid you're making yourself look? Somebody said to me once that it is wrong, okay, to be as honest as sometimes we are on this show, because you might offend people. Well, I just got offended, because there are people in this country who watch this show and people watching in this audience who need provides, not people who think it's okay. Thank you to the other guests this morning, who I believe actually... Thank you to this audience. I'll see you very soon. Take care. Bye-bye for now.